Hello, everybody. So today I am going to, actually over the next couple of days, I'm going to walk you guys through our experience replacing the nasty carpet in our Argosy that used to look like this and show you how we transformed it to look like this. We decided we wanted to get rid of the carpet in our Argosy for several reasons. Number one, it was really old. I don't even know who's used it, what animals have been on it, how long this thing sat in storage, so it had to go. It had stains on it. Two, we have animals ourselves, so I know that with camping, we're going to be making a mess anyway, even if we didn't have pets, but since we have dogs, carpet was just that much more likely to get destroyed. And three, just overall durability and comfort. So after lots of research, we settled on doing a 100% rubber vinyl plank flooring. We like this option because it's waterproof, which is really important to us because we have not completely remodeled our camper. And she unfortunately still has a couple leaks here and there. And again, pets. This is what works best for us and our needs for our camper. You may want to do something different. There's lots of great options out there, but I'm going to show you how we installed it and walk you through some things that make it a little bit tricky or different than doing it in a regular home. Getting rid of the carpet. Now comes the tough stuff. We gotta get the tack strip out and then we can start preparing where we're gonna lay the floor. Since the tack strip in these campers is generally fairly rotted out, it's not that hard to pull it up. You may not even need a hammer, but we're gonna use a flat blade screwdriver and a hammer and we're gonna get this stuff right out of here. Careful when you pull this stuff up. Obviously it has nails on the top, but it also has nails on the bottom, so make sure you properly dispose of it quickly. So once we have the tack strip out, we need to make sure that everything else is removed from the floor. We've got some nails sticking behind, some staples. So we're going to take a hammer and a flathead screwdriver, basically clean out anything that's sticking up out of this floor. And then we're gonna vacuum it and make sure we didn't miss anything.
Demo crew has gotten all the carpet out and all the staples and the cart and the targ. Carpet tack strip. There we go. We're gonna put a control line down the middle because that way it gives you start in the middle, out in the open. That way you know you got a long straight line and it's a lot easier to measure off of something defined to make your cuts and your notches than just a wing, you know. Okay, to get my control line, I looked for the longest, straightest edge that I could in here to go off of. These things here are right along the bottom of the skins. Got about 5 foot worth, but we got to snap all the way across the trailer in that. I could measure on this. That's only this little section. This is a different, it's a small section. So I just picked this area up here to, it gives me my longest, area that's the same depth. And we still have to snap it from there through that line all the way to the end.
So tell the camera what we're doing.
Okay, so I'm going to hold on this line down here at the end. And then I'm going to send her to the other end of the camper. And then I'm going to tell her to go one way or the other till it looks like the line's lined up right over this mark right here. And there we have a straight line. So we'll start the first row right off of that. And then we can pull measurements off of that and notches and all that.
So we decided to go with a very durable vinyl plank flooring. It's 100% waterproof. We used this in our other camper and we really, really liked it. It's very durable, very scratch resistant. This one has a pad under it. We're going with a Vericor brand, which we bought at Menards. And it's click and lock. You just lay it down. Very easy to install. I will give you guys a couple of tips about it later. Things to remember when installing. But this is the brand and the type of floor that we're going to be showing you how to install today. to install this type of flooring, you're going to need a couple of tools because you're going to have to make a lot of cuts. Obviously, it's always better if you can be putting your flooring in without all your cabinets and your walls in. But if you're like us and you're traveling in your Airstream in its original condition or in its existing condition, then you're going to have to make some modifications and it's going to take a little bit longer to install, but it's still going to be worth it at the end. So I'm going to tell you the things you need to get going. There's about a million different ways that you can cut this flooring. You'll see all kinds of tutorials on the internet about how to do it. We've decided to go the easy and fast way, so I bought this little Dremel saw max and I installed a plastic blade on it, so it's going to make cutting things very fast and very easy. That's the method we're going to use. I tried using a knife and it just wasn't getting it done because this floor is pretty heavy duty. You're also going to need a tape measure, obviously a pencil, and probably still need a knife and some other various tools that you'll be seeing throughout the project. One thing that is really important to remember when using a vinyl luxury plank is that you're going to need to give it room to contract and expand. Some people don't agree with putting this kind of flooring in an Airstream to begin with because of sunlight, sun exposure from the windows. It can contract and expand, especially if you are traveling in the winter and the summer. Obviously, these are very hard to temperature regulate throughout the year if you live anywhere besides the south. So if you are going to install this kind of flooring, we just recommend that you give it a little bit of room on the edges to expand and contract. Another thing that you can do is make sure you store the flooring inside the camper for a couple days before you install it and let it acclimate to its situation. Let's get going. And I'm going to show you how using the Dremel SawMax with a plastic blade is fast and easy. There's a notch here, which is what you line up with your line on your board that you've already drawn out after you've measured. And we're basically just going to follow along that notch and cut our board. How we're doing on our control line here. Looks pretty good. So let's keep going. Whenever you snap these together, you want to make sure that not only that they're clicking and locking, but that they're also lining up well, especially since we're not laying it row by row. This is going to affect you as you move down the line to your next piece. All right, we're still following our control line pretty well, so we're going to keep this up. And here in a minute, we'll put some screws in on this side so that this floor doesn't move around. Okay, so as you can see down here, we are ready to make our first cut. Couple things, don't make some rookie mistakes that are very easy to make, even if you've done this before. Number one is you want to take your measurement off of wherever you're going to take your measurement off of the next piece. I like to do it off of the edge of the actual wood or flooring, so we're going to take our measurement off of here. Number two, make sure that you are cutting from the correct end so that it can snap together properly. Once you've cut the other side, you can no longer use that board going in that direction. So it's important to make sure that I'm going to cut the lip side that matches this when I make my cut. I know that sounds easy, but it is a lot easier to screw up than you think it is. So let's get our measurement and make our cut. If you are worried about your ability to cut straight or to measure correctly, which can be difficult, I recommend starting at an end where you can come back and put some sort of decorative trim over it so that if, like in this case, your cut isn't perfect, you can still modify it later. Also, don't get frustrated because obviously nothing in these campers is straight or correct or plumb or anything. So, you know, this board isn't necessarily straight. This one is straight because we added it. But every board is going to be different and they're not all necessarily going to be straight. So you are going to have to modify along the way and probably plan on installing some sort of decorative trim around the space and still give it room to breathe and expand and contract. Keep in mind that you want to watch the pattern. So see how we've got a line there where we started a piece and a line down here. So for this next piece, I'm going to measure somewhere here in the middle. Another thing that's going to be important as you get closer to the wall where you're going to have to do more cutting is to make sure you take multiple measurements off of various sections of the same length of your board so that you can tell if this is in fact plumb or level or square, I guess is the better word, to your cut. So down here I'm at about 4 3/4 inches And down here, I'm at about 4 3/4 inches. So in this case, we're pretty good to go. We're not gonna have to make any diagonal cuts in this piece. We just need to make it 4 3/4 inches wide. And to make the pattern look good, I'm gonna do about 16 inches long. Okay, I'm gonna be real with you guys. So yesterday I was working on the floor and it was going okay at first, and I was putting some footage together to give you guys tips on what to do. And then it started getting really difficult and I got really frustrated and I was like, I don't want to do a tutorial with all these problems that are happening. But I woke up this morning and decided a true Airstream tutorial should show you all the good, the bad, and the ugly. And even though we've laid this kind of flooring in multiple home projects, we've never done it in a space where there have been quite so many cuts. So even though we're familiar with the process and we know what we're doing, it's definitely been a little challenging because we've got some walls here that need to be cut slash taken care of. We've got different angles, different depths of cabinetry and things that are pretty complicated. But I'm gonna show you all that today and show you the nitty gritty and show you what you're really gonna be dealing with. So we've gotten a decent amount of it laid, but I'm gonna start off with telling you some things that are gonna come up when you try to do your flooring, and we'll see if I can be any help. Well, our first issue was here at the wall. I decided initially we were gonna just keep the wall and put the flooring around it, but then we realized it was gonna be really hard to get it to click and lock underneath the wall. So we ultimately decided to take a multi-tool and cut the wall shorter. It wasn't attached to anything here anyway, so we went ahead and cut the wall shorter so that we could slide the hardwood under it. So we had to leave a bigger gap than we wanted to over here, and that's why it's not a very clean cut. So we've decided that we're going to install some sort of trim piece that sits up here and covers the gap. So now we're a little less worried about it being perfect. But it's kind of frustrating to not be able to have it be cut a little bit more cleanly. So I'm going to show you this next piece where we're going to have to make a cut around a corner here and show you how difficult it is to install basically what is the last row. I'm realizing now that I messed up. I didn't mess up, I forgot a measurement, because I just noticed that on the other side of this wall, this cabinet comes back out to get another length. So I've got one more cut to make here. We better take that measurement. Keep in mind, I understand there's a lot of other tools and ways to do everything. I'm sure some people watching this video will say, she should have been using a square, and why wasn't she using a square? Why didn't she use a pencil the entire time? Well, this doesn't have to be exact, so I'm kind of using tools that I had available since my husband is on a different job site, and that are fast. Okay, another reason I like to kind of lay out the piece where it's going to be when I make my measurements is it's a lot easier for me than to visually double check that I am indeed making the correct drawing on my board before I cut it. Now for the difficult part of sliding it under the already existing wall. Now see, this is what I mean by you really just want to give yourself extra gap, because since I haven't yet installed it, this piece is also sticking out. So now my cut is too tight for me to get it under the wall. So I'm going to have to go back and trim this off a little bit. Okay, so it is, but now we've got way too much length still here. So we're gonna make another cut. Hopefully this is the last one. Like I said, I decided I wanted to show you guys all this, not because we don't know what we're doing or because I've never done this, even though that's what it looks like, but it's because it's a camper and it's totally different than a house. It's totally different than any other space you've worked in. And I really wanted to give you guys a real sense of what it's actually like, not just a fake perspective of how to get something done with actually no helpful tips. So, okay, I think maybe this is going to work. We're gonna try it. We may need to take a little bit more off of this end. But let's see here. I think we're gonna be able to get this done. So I'm just rocking it back and forth, trying to get it installed. This is nice to have two people, but unfortunately, my husband is on a different job site today, so I am all my own. There we go. And when you do get it in place, you'll kind of hear it click. Struggling right underneath, of course, where this door is. If he were here, he would be able to hit it with a fist. But he's not, so let's try this. You want to be careful when you're doing this. Make sure you don't damage the floor. I think that's it. I think we got it. Nope. There we go. Nope. I don't think that's installed. Let's see down here. There we go. Okay, now we got it. Now we just need to gently tap down here at the end so that we can connect to that. We'll be good. We are connected, ladies and gentlemen. So see, it's a little bit more difficult than it appeared to be at first, but we got it done. So doing a little check-in, we've got this side of the camper done. We really didn't have anything else come up that I felt like I needed to show you guys how to do that was out of the ordinary, just some kind of difficult cuts. But we did get it done, and so now we are getting ready to start on this side of the camper going the other direction. I plan on this being a 2-day project, and of course, as all things Airstream seem to go, it ended up being like a 4-day project because I also had a bunch of other stuff to get done in the meantime. But it's looking pretty good, so I think we'll be able to finish it up today. As you can see here, we've got quite a gap. That's because I wasn't able to get the piece to lay down. So of course, we're just gonna have to do a piece of trim across here to cover the gap. Questions about or might wonder why I did or didn't do them. So number one is subfloor. You could of course do a second layer of subfloor under this. A lot of people would underlay it. This has a rubber attachment on it. Also, we're well aware that in a couple years we're going to have to completely remodel this camper because it does have some soft spots in the floor and some leaks. So even though we're putting this down and we want to keep it for a while, it's also not something we're going to have for 5-10 years in here. So if we were doing this for a customer, we would probably do an underlayment under this. But this does say that you don't have to have an underlayment. So that's that. The other thing is, obviously, there's a million different techniques for installation. One of the biggest things that's frustrating is none of these walls or cabinets or doors are straight, so you might have to make a couple different cuts. This tool that I use, this saw, I have mixed feelings about it. In some ways it worked really well because it kind of let me make my crooked cuts if I needed to, but I wouldn't recommend this for a project where you need it to be super, super straight. But it did do pretty good. It definitely cut it just fine and was very fast, but I wouldn't use this for something that I needed an exact straight cut for, but since we're going to be doing trim pieces anyway, it was totally fine and it didn't really matter. So this did work well for $89. I think it was just fine. The biggest things to keep in mind are that you want to make sure that it is really locked in place, and you want to hear that final kind of click and see that it lays a little bit flat, because sometimes the pieces aren't locked in place as well as you think they are. And you want to make sure that you give yourself plenty of a gap, not just for the fact that it makes installation easier, but also for the fact that then the floor can expand and contract. And one thing for general maintenance for wear and tear on this is to kind of definitely, if you're going to be gone all day and you're going to be out in the hot sun somewhere, if you've got curtains, keep your curtains closed. I know that some people have said that when you get really heavy sunspots on certain areas of the floor, it can kind of buckle or melt or bend up. We didn't have that problem in our other camper. I think as long as you keep the camper temperature regulated, it should be fine. But if I were going to be doing a floor in a place I was going to be living in for a long period of time, I don't know that I would go with rubber flooring for my Airstream just because of the temperature changes, if that's your situation. But for us, we use it on the weekends. It's perfect for the pets. It's waterproof. So for our needs, it works really great. You might find that for your needs, you either want something a little bit more resistant to heat and cold and temperature change, and you might want something that is a little bit more permanently installed. So, all right, let's finish this up.